Don't do that. Right, we'll get Farley in there.
Why don't we sit next to
him? Yeah, we could. Hi, and welcome to another Go Rural Lambathon.
Hi.
We're farming in the Scottish Borders. I'm Jasmine, and this is Fennec. And this is our newest addition, Baby Farley. So we're going to take you on a tour today of our farm. We're in the south of Scotland in the Scottish Borders, and we have 435 acres. And we're going to take you to see some sheep that are lambing at the moment. We have a visitor attraction on our farm as well, and we do farm tours. So today, Fennec's going to take me for a trip in the tour trailer, and he's going to drive and pop Baby Farley in his car seat, and he's going to take us for a trip. So I'll just go and get in the tour trailer. I'll flip the camera around and we'll go and get in. So when visitors come to the farm, one of the things they can do here is they can come on a farm tour or a lambing experience, and we climb on up into this trailer. It takes, in a non-COVID year, up to 12 people, but at the minute we're just taking households. So Fennec's just putting the baby in the car, and he's going to come and shut us in so that we can start our tour. We're at the moment, we're just at the front of our farmhouse at the moment. That's us shut in. So the ramp is so that we can get wheelchairs in here. So everything we do on the farm is accessible. We're really passionate about making everything accessible. These are the tie downs for the wheelchairs. Just there, they're actually, I'm storing some compost here as well. There are the tie downs for the wheelchairs. And I'd better sit down, as the sign says. Fennec's just about to pull off. So that's actually our kids' toys in the garden. So we're just going to drive off, and Fennec's going to take us up to the lambing fields. A bit rattly in the trailer, but this is what you would be seeing if you were travelling in the trailer. This here is part of our visitor attraction that we run. So that's the main shed that we use as a reception and where the pet lambs are. And on the other side of the trailer, through the hedge, you won't be able to see a lot, but if I look over the top, our Highland cows are there. There's our Highland cows, and they're the self-guided visitor paddocks. People get a leaflet on arrival and they self-tour themselves around our paddocks. There's our little tractor for the kids to play on, and they get bags of animal food when they get here, and they go off and feed them. So this is us going up the farm road, which is the road you'll come down when you come visit the farm. Go on the other side, and we are just heading into what we usually use as a car park. So this is what we use as a car park. And at the top of this field, where those big white bales are, we'll drive into the field, what we call the horse park. So in the horse park, we have some sheep lambing at the moment. So we'll see them soon. It's quite windy today. It's not rain. It's quite noisy in the trailer. It's not actually raining at the moment today, so we're very lucky. It's been raining all morning. Some of our small Shetland flock. We have a really small flock of Shetland sheep on the farm. So that's them over there. We have about over a thousand sheep to lamb on the farm this year. And in this field that we're about to go into is just a small number of them. It's going to be pretty bumpy as we go through here, because in the winter we've been in here accessing those white bales with lots of tractors. So it's very rutted and muddy just in the gateway. So in this field we've got what we call hogs. So our hogs are lambing twins in this field. Hogs are sheep that are not lambs anymore, but they're not yet fully grown sheep. So they're having their first set of lambs. And we should drive around here and see quite a few lambs jumping about the field. These ones that we're just about to come up to are actually just lying down, having an afternoon nap. There they are. So Fennec's going to try and drive as close as he can get to them. We come in and out this field at least 3 times a day, so they get plenty of care. This one here, actually, it's got red on her bum. You won't see many of the sheep with colours on them, but she actually had what we call a prolapse. and she had a wee bit of care. She got stitched up, and last night she birthed 2 wee lambs, so that was a very successful story. Yep, Fennec's asking if we want him to keep going. There's a... Hello. Fennec's driving today, which is unusual. I'm a bit of a control freak. Usually I do the driving, but I thought I'd try and give you guys a good tour of the fields by being in the trailer, so we're separate today. I also usually do the driving because I hate getting the gates, so the rule is on the farm that anyone who's passenger has to get out and get all the gates. Hi to Abby Moore. Hi from Galashiels. So Galashiels is not far from us. It takes us about half an hour to get to Galashiels. That's where we do a lot of our food shopping. Or Fennec does the food shopping. I'm not allowed in the supermarkets. Tend to spend far too much time in the middle aisle of Aldi. Spend too much money. Hello to Stephen from Fife. So if you have any questions while we're going round, pop a question in the box and I'll try and answer it. And if we don't see it or we can't answer it at the time, I'll go through the comments afterwards and answer it. So everyone in the field seems pretty peaceful today. Despite it being pretty cold and windy, they're all lying down quite happy. Hi to Hannah from Brechin and Oklahoma, Yorkshire. It's amazing to see where everyone's from. So while I'm on, Go Rural is doing these Lambathons every day. Throughout the springtime, to let everyone know what happens in the lambing fields of Scotland at this time of year. And we're also trying to promote all the fabulous businesses in Scotland that don't only do farming all year round, but also run different businesses on their farms. So if you head to goruralscotland.com, you'll be able to see people who do accommodation, farm tours, visitor attractions, all sorts of different businesses, lots of places to go and eat, farm shops. If you head over to goruralscotland.com, you can find all about that. And we're running a competition at the moment on the website. So if you go to the website and enter the competition, you can get a chance to win a tour for 4 people at Lennox of Lomond. Lennox of Lomond were filmed yesterday doing the Lambathon, and they are offering a tour for 4 people on their farm and their quad bike and trailer experience. So if you want a chance of winning that, then head over to the Go Rural website. It's just quite a simple question to answer that you'll find the answer to if you look on the website or watch yesterday's tour. Hi from Durham. Hi everyone who's watching. Hello. So we did quite a lot of these tours last year during lockdown, and it was great to see everybody from all different parts of the world. I'll just cast the camera up a little bit to the countryside that you can see. We live in a really beautiful part of the world. Everywhere is beautiful in its own way, but I really love living here. Fern says, how many are you lambing and what problems have they had? So we're lambing over 1,000 sheep on the farm this year. Problems tend to be, you could have prolapses, or you could have lambs that get stuck. Jedburgh, our main problem would be a lamb that gets stuck. All our sheep are lambed outside. So anything that has a problem, we use the sheepdog to help us catch it, and we just give it a bit of helping hand. But we selectively breed for sheep that are good mothers and lamb themselves, so the problems we have are quite minimal. The prolapse we saw today, we have wrung the tails of the lambs, so we don't take the tails off most lambs on this farm, but we did wring her lamb's tails, and that just means we're selectively making sure that we don't keep them. So we're selectively breeding for ones that are not going to have a prolapse. So if the mother's had a prolapse, we won't keep any offspring from her. Someone said, do you have accommodation or a B&B? We don't on this farm, but there's a farm right across the valley from us, Bairnkin Holiday Cottages. They do farm stays, B&Bs, and they have a spot for camper vans. So anyone who goes and visits them not only can stay on a farm and see what's happening on their farm, they can also walk straight from their farm to our farm and book in for a lambing experience or an open day. So we actually open our farm up to the public as a visitor attraction every weekend throughout the year. So people book on with us at the weekends to come and visit the farm and visit all the animals, and then through the week they book on for exclusive farm tours and experiences. So this field has just been lambing for just over a week. So there's not lots of lambs in here. There were a few at the gateway when we came in, and the rest are currently waiting to have their lambs. So they're full of lambs, the rest of them. That's Bairnkin just cottages. Bairnkin cottages just commented. So if anyone wants to come and stay in this beautiful area and see their farm, you can see their link in the comments below. So the breed of sheep we have on this farm is a wool shedding breed that Fenwick bred himself. And the idea of the breed is in its name. So these guys in front of us, you can see they're starting to lose their wool. So we breed them to lose their wool themselves so we don't have to shear it off. Wool's not worth a lot of money these days. You have to pay the shearer to do it and you don't get an awful lot back for it in return. So we're breeding, selectively breeding for sheep that lose their wool and also for sheep that are great mothers and don't need a lot of interference throughout the year. So the sheep get plenty of care and attention and we look them for health every day, more than once a day this time of year. But we are selectively breeding, so anything that has any problems doesn't stay on the farm and neither does its offspring. Do you have, Finn says, do you have other breeds apart from Shetlands and what tups do you put to use? So we do have other breeds. We've got the main breed we have is the wool shedders. We have a small flock of Shetlands and we also have a small flock of Texels. So we have some wool shedding tups like you were asking. We also have some Texel tups. Here's the cows. We're just driving past the cows now that are calving. We also have some Texel tups and we have a Roussan and we have some strange tups. Fenwick likes to experiment a lot with the livestock we have on the farm. Thank you for the info on the B&B. Can you repeat the name of the farm you mentioned opposite your farm? So if you look there, that's our farm steading and just above it on the hill you can see another farm. So that's Bairnkin. Bairnkin, Lucy from Bairnkin's actually popped a comment in the box below this. So after the tour, if you go and have a look at the comments, you should be able to find the link to Bairnkin Holiday Cottages. Finn says he's never heard of ewes that shed. So there's a couple of different breeds that shed their wool, and by breeding them to traditional breeds in this country and then selecting the ones that shed their wool, you can almost create your very own wool shedding breed. Some people buy in a breed, Easy Cares. Bairnkin can have them as well. Here's a sheep and lamb right in front of us, running off to the side. So there's lots of lovely places to stay in Scotland. You could even do a whole tour if you wanted to. You could start in the south of Scotland in the borders and stay on as many farms as you possibly can before you get to the north. There's lots of members of Go Rural have accommodation, and if you go to the website you'll find that, as well as be able to enter the competition they're running. This lamb is quite fresh here. It's just born this morning, I think. Now we are heading back past this one. Someone asked about what problems do you have. So this is a prolapse who successfully gave birth to two lambs last night. Hello to Hamish Nine Fingers. So what we're going to do is we're just going to head out of the lambing field and we're head back down the road towards our farmyard. Going to go over this really bumpy bit again, and then when we get to the yard what we'll be able to see is we'll be able to go into the shed and see our pet lamb department. So any lamb that's been orphaned or been taken away from its mother because it wasn't thriving gets brought into the shed and gets bottle reared by us. So we'll go and have a look at the pet lambs. We'll have a look at everything else that's in the shed. We've got a couple of goats in there and a pet calf as well. It's quite unusual for us to have a pet calf. Cows usually just have single births and they don't have multiples like sheep do, so there's often usually a lot less problems. But for whatever reason, this mother of this calf abandoned it, so we're raising a pet calf at the moment too. And we'll be able to show you just what the entrance of the visitor attraction looks like as well. So here we are passing our small flock of Shetlands again. Our farm trail is quite noisy. I have taken it for a small tour before, but I haven't been right up into that bumpy field there, so I wonder if we maybe need some blockers on our trailer ramp. Although I suppose it all adds to the experience. So there's our Shetlands we're driving past. And this is our farm steading. So all these sheds are part of our farmyard. And if I swing back round, these are the farm cottages, and in the field behind is our visitor paddocks. There's our border collie Lynn just waiting for us. So anytime I ever need to find Fennec, I usually find his dog first, because she's usually really close to him and she knows he's in the car, so she's waiting on him. So we can't, he can't really escape me, he can't hide, because the dog's always around. Dog's usually no more than 20 metres away from him, so if I can find the dog, I usually know that he's somewhere nearby. So that's Lynn. She also guards all the vehicles in and out of the farm. She'll escort every vehicle that comes to the farm into the yard, and she'll escort every vehicle out as well. She likes to know that people have left. So this is our visitor attraction. We'll have a container here that's currently being done up so that we can serve some nice ice creams out of it in the summer, and people can buy some cards. We've got pictures taken of the animals in the fields that we sell as cards. Cut a welly up and make some rubber washers for the back door to stop that noise. We could go round another field. Fennec's asking where we want to go next. Should we go round another field before we go to the shed? See the cow, Highland cows and the sheep in there. So Fennec's just going to take us into this field here, which is called the Cow Gang. All the fields on the farm have a name. They've been passed down by generations. So he's going to take us into what we call the Cow Gang. So this is the top of our visitor attraction paddocks. You can see our bins. But they're nice bins because they're from Whiskey Barrels, our tractor for the kids to have a look at. And our pig igloo, our pigloo, is there because we have a pig at the bottom of the field who has piglets at the moment. And everyone wants to know what the igloo is like inside, but they can't go in because the pig's there. So we've put a spare one up the top of the paddock here for people to climb inside and see what it's like. So we'll just go into the Cow Gang, they call it. So we're gonna, you can see the Highland cows from here. They're those brown dots just in front of us. And that grey tube that you can see there is how people feed the animals when they come to the farm. So they pop their food pellets in their end of the pipe, and the food pellets drop out the other end of the pipe into that white bucket at the bottom. Fennec's shutting the gates. He's a proper good farmer. When I come in and out, I leave the gates open. And last week I came back from doing a tour, and Fennec was trying to herd the Highland cows back into the field. He wasn't very happy with me, so he knows he has to shut the gates to set an example, otherwise he's a hypocrite. He's saying cows don't get out if you close the gates. He's quite right. The cows just went for a wee walk down there, and they went to say hello to the people who live in the cottages, and they came back. They just had a nice scenic tour. So in between these two fences you've got here is where people walk down. So we fence the animals off the people, so people are nice and safe. He needs to get a speaker in the trailer so he can yell at you. We actually do have one. I've got a walkie-talkie on the roof so that I can do tours, and I have a walkie-talkie in the car, but I'm not going to tell Fennec how to switch it on. So here's some of our Highland cows. They're a really small fold of Highland cows. We've got about 15 on the farm, but we've only got 3 in this field. So we've got 2 that have calves beside them, and we have 1 who's yet to calf. So that one there is Bill. He spent a night in our utility room a few months back. He just had a wee bit struggling to feed to start with, but then he spent 24 hours with us, had a little bit of help start, and he's back in the field with his mum. So that was a good story. So people were asking earlier, what breed of sheep do we have? And I said we had some Texels, so here they are. These ones at the front, the white ones. The one at the back is actually a pet lamb of ours from 2 years ago, who's just had twins this year. She was called Panda. These are a few of our Texels. There are Texel singles that were lambed inside the shed. Nearly all the sheep lamb outside, but we just popped the singles inside the shed so we could control the food intake they were having. So their lambs didn't get too big. If you look in that little arc, you'll see our goats as you drive past. We have 2 meat goat variety and 1 milking goat. So I'm really hoping to grow the meat goat herd that we've got. Pig's in its shed, so we're probably not going to see that today. See, that lamb's on the wrong side of the fence. It'll find its way back. So people can walk down and see our pig. You can see how messy the pig is. The pig moved in there a month ago, and a month ago her grass looked like this, and now it looks like that. So she spent most of her month before she had her piglets churning the whole ground up. Oh, Fennec's coming to a stop. I think that Fennec's probably stopping so we can show you the piglets. There is pride and joy, these little piglets. There he is, running over the fences to show you. So our pig's called Abby. She was a wedding present that was given to us just about 2 years ago. Oh, there come the piglets. My brother turned up at the farm the day after we got married and dropped two pigs on us. So Jay has supplied us with lovely homegrown pork for the past year, and Abby, this one's called Abby, has supplied us with some beautiful piglets. So it's this, the wedding present that keeps on giving. Here's Abby. She's huge. So it is supposed to be Lambathon, but you can't miss out on the piglets because they're just fantastic. Well, I can't quite see them from the trailer. Usually what we do is we stop here on our tours, we down the ramp, we let people over the fence, and we go and have a really good chat with the piglets. But Fennec hasn't let me out, so I'm not allowed to today. But there you are, they're running about. So the piglets have only been out for 3 days. Most of the people that came to our last weekend open didn't get to see the piglets because it was absolutely roasting hot and it was too hot for Abby to come out. And then on Sunday night we let the piglets out for the first time to roam about the field, and this is them now getting a good view of Scotland. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to turn in a circle and head back to the shed so we can have a quick look at the pet lambs before 1:30, before we finish. So if you haven't watched one of these videos before, there's one on every day at the moment on Go Rural Facebook page, showing everybody what's happening in the fields of Scotland at lambing time, letting people see the farmers that supply our nation and further afield with food, and to showcase all the wonderful businesses that farmers are also running as well as farming every day. So you can see a sheep on the wrong side of the fence there. So there's so many businesses that are running more than a farm. There's accommodation businesses, visitor attractions, all sorts. So that's the aim of Go Rural, is to promote all that, to let people see what's happening in farming, and to encourage people to get outdoors. There's no better time than this time to be outdoors, because everyone needs to be far apart from everyone anyway. So it's a great opportunity to go and explore Scottish farms this year if you're in Scotland, or if you're not able to get to Scotland this year, to plan it for the future. Bruce is saying thanks to all the farmers who do 24/7, 365. And he's quite right. Thank you to everybody. We produce meat on our own farm, but we of course buy it in the shops as well. We don't buy lamb in the shops, but we buy chicken and we buy pork, and that's all made by farmers. So thank you, and it really is 24/7. Even more 24/7 when we're running a visitor attraction as well. We've got a 9-week-old baby in the front of the Land Rover that Fennec's driving about as well. So we're working an incredible amount of hours, but it's very rewarding. It doesn't feel like work. It's a way of life working on the farm. And actually welcoming visitors to the farm is a really, really lovely thing to do if you're a people person. We both like people, we both love the farm, we both like being outdoors. So it's a perfect way to diversify our income, to mean that I can stay at home and not have to work away. And it's really sociable for us. We get to tour our fields like this and look at all the sheep without having to actually feel like we're working, and we get to tell everybody about what we do, which I think is really important, that kids know where their meat comes from. So we run 75 toddlers come to the farm every week at the moment with their parents during the weekdays, kids that don't go to school yet, and they come and they learn about the farm. So this morning Fennec was running a toddler session, so they took a walk down to see the pig. Here's some lambs jumping here. They took a walk down to see the pig, and then he took them all into the back of the chicken house. They all collected an egg each, and they set them into an incubator. So our toddlers are incubating eggs over the next 21 days. So on their third week, they're gonna see their eggs that they collected. They're gonna see chicks hatch out of them. Thank you, Wendy. And thank you, Dee Dee, who says she's enjoying the tour. Wonderful lifestyle from Toronto. Yeah, it is great. It's really, really, really lovely thing to be able to do. So Fennec's going to open and shut this gate so that we can get out, and I'm gonna go and jump into the pet lamb pen. I think I'll probably actually just jump straight out the trailer while he's opening the gates, so we don't have to bother waiting, and we'll meet him in the shed. So we'll meet Fennec in the shed. It's quite windy here, so I hope you can still hear me. We live in a really windy place. There's almost no protection between the prevailing wind and our farm. So this is the pigloo that Abby lives in, and all our stuff has signs against it so the visitors can learn about what's happening on the farm. This is our old Ford 4000. It still works on the farm, although we have a bigger tractors for most of the jobs. And at the weekends, this is blocked off at the minute, but at the weekends, this is how people get from the animal paddocks into the shed, which has all the toilets in it, and the play paddocks. So this is our picnic area. We have two picnic areas. We have one here, and then when people finish their farm walk, there's a picnic area up there as well. This is one of our picture signs where you can get your picture taken behind it when you come visit the farm, with that amazing view behind it. And this is our play area. So we've got a 360 digger in these tires and some toys, and our chicken run, which the kids love. Every child that comes to the farm, one of their favourite animals is usually the chickens. So we'll go ahead and see the pet lambs, who have just been fed, so they're probably all in a heap having a nice sleep. But this is our shed. So when people come to the farm, they come out the field that we were in, the car park, they come down past the Land Rover, they get their tickets here, and then they come on in here to use the toilets. So we've got disabled toilet light, the trailer, all our facilities are access friendly. So we've got disabled toilets and our pets. So here's the pet calf that I was talking about. And here are our lambs having a little afternoon snooze. So they're all just having a relax on the bales. They've just been fed. I'll see if I can get up nice and close, because if people are here for Lambathon, I'm guessing they want to see some lambs. And the ones out in the field are well protected by their very good mothers. So if we come in here, come on, boys. We can see their lambs. Fennec says, come on, boys. I'm sure there's a girl in here somewhere, but... So they're all... He's waking them up. What a shame. There we go. They're probably expecting food now. Although they do get a lot of visitors coming to say hello to them that don't have food. So these guys get bottle fed 3 times a day. They get a powdered milk, like mixed with water, like if you were formula feeding a baby, a human baby, except the milk is a different mixture, of course. And they drink out the bottle, and they will always stay friendly. So the pet lambs we had last year and the year before still come and say hello to us in the field. So these guys are really, really well humanised, so they're not frightened at all when we come to see them and we come to feed them. So how many have we got here? We've got 7. 7 pet lambs out of a lot of sheep, which is not too bad. Not too bad at all. The lambs love a bit of human interaction. And next door we've got our goats, which are obsessed with human interaction. They absolutely love it. Usually these guys are not even in here. This one, which one is it? Lottie. This one's Lottie. She's hardly ever in the pen because she can jump out. So Lottie was actually named by a parent on one of our live videos that we do as a farm, because she watched a lot of the live videos we did last year when she was pregnant. And now that she's had her baby, she's called it Lottie. So she named this goat Lottie. So hopefully one day we'll get to meet the little girl that the goat's named after. So where's Fennec? Fennec's looking at his eggs. These are the eggs that Fennec's incubating with our kids that come to the toddler session. So we've got 2 incubators going here. So they will hatch chickens soon. So what we'll do now before the end is we'll just say thank you for watching, and we hope you tune in to more Go Rural Lambathons if you can. Someone said earlier to smile, so you have to smile. Thanks for watching, and we hope you visit a Scottish farm that's running a diversification agritourism business sometime soon. And goodbye from the lambs. And don't forget, if you want to enter the competition to win a farm tour at Lennox of Loch Lomond, then go to gorural.com, goruralscotland.com, and fill in their question. Bye.
Nice to see you. Bye.
Smile. Wait a minute. Smile. There we go. He does smile.